So, sit in your room, close your eyes and sit in a comfortable posture. Observe if your nerves and muscles are relaxed. From head to foot, relax all your muscles and nerves. And then you begin to observe the movements of your respiration. Then automatically this fellow begins to approach him. But daily you have to do it. That's the reason why we have to observe as far as possible that our routine is not disturbed and we do not make any journeys, because we are helpless when we make journeys. Suppose we are the guests of a person who does not believe in God and prayer. We have to do it in mind, not doing outside. Therefore, keep the timings carefully and then begin to observe the movements of your respiration. Gradually the mind comes to the heart and automatically the mind begins to rest there. And after 2 minutes of this practice, you make your respiration slow, steady and uniform. Let your respiration be made soft and let it be uniform. One of the injunctions of Kriya Yoga given in Bhagavad Gita is, understand that there is an inward pull of the respiration and there is an outward pull for the respiration, which are automatic. They are creating the exhalation and inhalation. How the automatic process is applying to your lungs, and make it uniform. Let there be a rhythm in your respiration. Just as the musician establishes a rhythm in his song, you begin to establish a rhythm in your respiration, which was there in your childhood, which is disturbed when you are growing in age. Whenever there is some fear, it is disturbed. Whenever there is anger, whenever there is jealousy, whenever there is suspicion, it was disturbed. And we disturbed it 1,000 times a day. And after a certain age, that is about 35 or 40 years, we find that there is no rhythm in our respiration because of a continuous misbehavior with our thoughts. Again, establish the rhythm by making a soft, slow respiration. Begin to breathe in continuously with a uniform speed and softly as much as you can without any discomfort. When it is full, you stop it and then make the exhalation in the same way, slow, soft and uniform, as much as you can without any discomfort. Stop it. Again do it. Like that, you make 3 respirations. Then leave it free for a few moments. Again make 3 respirations. Leave it and again make 3 respirations. In the beginning, 9 respirations are enough. And then leave it free. Take the second process. As long as you are inhaling, meditate upon the syllable sound so. And as long as you are exhaling, meditate upon a syllable hum. As long as you are inhaling, mentally utter the syllable so, like that. And as long as you are exhaling, vocally continuously utter hum. For example, like this, hum. Listen to your own voice, without which the practice is a waste. This is the second step. Do it 3 times, leave it free, again 3 times, leave it free and again 3 times. This is the second step you are to practice. And the third step is, mentally utter Om as long as you are inhaling. And utter vocally the same thing as long as you are exhaling and listen to your own voice while uttering. Without any discomfort. Do it 3+3+3 times. This is one set of practice in the beginning. After a few weeks, you can double it if there is no discomfort. If you feel it happy, continue it. And then the miracle happens. You are proposing to utter it, then you will understand that your mind received the proposal from the Lord. Then you thought of uttering it. Then you will understand that it is a call from the Lord. But at first it is a call from you to the Lord. And if you are lucky enough to practice it uniformly, and if we are not foolish to believe that we have more important things to do, then after a few months we begin to listen to the call of the Lord. But if we have some things which are more important than this in our life, it is better not to practice yoga. Because even though for 50 years we do it, the call of the Lord is not there because we have not called him. So here lies the secret of success or failure. Only one individual item contributes to the success or a thorough failure. If we have something which is more important than this in our life at all, then the whole thing goes a waste. Better to spend the time in eating and drinking and dancing than to waste our time in yoga. So this is what is called making a total surrender to the Lord.